that has to be. So you prune your item set and drop. Now, what are the extraction options? So the first decision was about sample size and factor loadings. The second decision that we think about is what should be the extraction options. Now, the most common in factor analysis that we are so familiar with and we study is what we call as the principal component analysis, right? PCA. This is the most common thing that is done when we are doing factor analysis. But I want to tell you here that PCA is actually not a factor analysis method. Okay, the method for factor analysis is what we call as the principal axis factoring. What is the difference between principal axis factoring and PCA? PCA actually works on, it tries to identify factors based on the variance of X observed. So it works on the total variance of the item, which is X observed is true plus error, right? Remember we had written X observed is equal to X true plus measurement error of X, right? So PCA is trying to minimize the all of the variance. It is working on the total variance. But this is not true because we are not interested in variance of analyzing variance of observed. We are actually interested in analyzing the variance of X true, not the observed. So what is actually the method that works on variance of X of observed minus variance of measurement error is principal axis factoring. It works on variance of X true, which is nothing but variance of X observed minus variance of measurement error, right? So this is the analysis method that we should follow when we are doing principal axis or we are doing exploratory factor analysis. We should actually be using the analysis method of principal axis factoring and not the method of principal component analysis. This method of PCA is nothing but a pure data reduction method. You may actually get, it is possible you will get very similar results between PCA and PAF, but remember, theoretically, principal component analysis is not a factor extraction method. It is just a simple data reduction method, and that is something that we should not be following. Okay, let me actually take you to where you can actually, if you have to cite some literature to your thesis committee or to wherever you are working, you can actually go to Madhu Vishwanathan's chapter and look at page number, just give me a minute. Yes, you can go to page number 32 of your book, of this chapter, page number 32. Okay, and if you have to cite, look at this. Another distinction in factor analysis is in using principal component analysis and common factor analysis. Essentially, variance of each item can be divided into error variance, specific variance, and common variance shared with other items, right? This is what we have been talking about, error variance, which is combination of these, plus the common variance that is due to the latent factor. In other words, responses to each item reflect some error, some content unique to the item and some content shared with other items. An item on PNI scale has some content unique to the item, some content presumably preference for numerical information shared with other. The content unique to an item would depend on specific context of the item and the wording. In a narrow sense, the item is a measure of some unique and likely very concrete thing. If one item on PNI is influenced by social desirability in wording and others are not, then social desirability contributes to unique content in an item that does not co-vary with other items. Each item also has unique content in the way it is worded. Principal components analysis uses all variants available and is a pure data reduction technique. Whereas common factor analysis, which is called as principal access factor analysis, uses only the common variants shared by variables and is more appropriate for conceptually driven examination of the data. The nature of factor extraction that is meaningful for scales with a common core is one that works off the common variance across items rather than one that is a pure data reduction technique. That is principal components analysis. This is because such common variance shared among items reflects the conceptual meaning of a factor that relates to an underlying construct. Using a pure data reduction technique that takes advantage of all variation and chance correlations is inconsistent with the goal of capturing conceptual meaning shared across items within a factor. Okay, so when you are doing factor analysis, remember you can cite this. I have also uploaded a paper, Conway and Huffcutt. This is also a review and evaluation of exploratory factor analysis. This is published in a very good journal, Organization Research Methods. Again, you can look at, go to page, I'm just highlighting the page number 150, selection of the factor extraction model. Okay. If researchers' purpose is to understand later structure of a set of variables, then use of a common factor model such as principal access or maximum likelihood factoring represents a high quality decision. If a researcher's purpose is pure reduction of variables without interpreting the resulting variables in terms of latent constructs, then use of PCA represents a high quality decision. Okay, so even if research goal involves latent construct, it has been claimed that PCA is a good substitute for common factor analysis and gives almost identical results. But although PCA results may very closely resemble common factor results, there are other cases in which noticeable differences emerge. Okay, and therefore in the paper they mention that it is better we should actually go for principal access factoring and not principal component analysis. So you can, and I have also in additional, I have given these two papers. These are also on exploratory analysis, evaluating exploratory analysis and research, and again, best practices in exploratory factor analysis. All these papers actually, if you read, they mentioned that we should not do principal component analysis in scale development. If you are interested in understanding latent factor structures, okay, you should actually go for principal access factoring. Maximum likelihood factor analysis is also similar to principal access factoring, but it has very strong assumptions of normality. Okay, so that is a big concern in this method. It assumes normality of the data, and most of the times Likert data is not normal. So therefore, this is something that is, I would personally recommend that you can just go think of principal access factor analysis if you are doing exploratory factor analysis, right? So that is something that you can. People often assume that extraction procedures are largely interchangeable, okay? And the default options are most sensible choices. If you, when we will do example in SPSS, the default extraction option comes out to be as, in SPSS, the default is PCA. But remember, the default may not be right. We will think of choosing principal axis factoring, principal axis factor analysis when we are going to do our extraction using in extraction.